Yeah, let's take a look at the this segment of our live box breaks here on Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Out of the gates, we're going to take care of all you Rick and Morty fans who may not be sports people but are curious to know what this product looks like because you haven't picked
it
up yet.
Fresh tweet. Let everybody know. Retweet this tweet to let your friends know to get in here. Tag a friend that's a gamer or a nerd or a geek that's not normally a card collector and let them know we are doing something unique and fun over here at Go GTS Live because this is the first ever Rick and Morty card set. And I know that their fans, again, it's doubled in price on the secondary market. Really, it's still the primary market, right? How do you consider that? Hobby shops are selling it for double because of the demand. No one told them to. Demand is so high.
Well, yeah, I checked Blowout the other day, and boxes were 180. I checked the next day, they were 190. I checked the next day, they were 200. And we've been sold out for, I mean, pretty much the minute it was solicited. Basically every generation has their counterculture animated show. I mean, for me, it would have been Ren and Stimpy, Beavis Butthead, and The Simpsons, and then Simpsons crossed into super mainstream, I think, so maybe fell off a little bit. Then South Park was for another generation, and now there's a generation that are Rick and Morty. And just
and Family
so
Guy
that
fell
I knew,
in between there.
Yeah, and Family Guy South fell Park in between and- there, for sure. And so I binged watched the first season, which this product is based
so
on, just so I could have some context to discuss. Wubba dubba dubba, all you Rick and Morty fans out there. But we're going to do something different with this box. We're not going to give away just the hits. We're going to give away the hits. One winner will get all of the inserts, another will get all the parallels, and another winner will get the base set. Because chatter was going crazy on Instagram and Twitter, according to the assets this afternoon. And so based on that, we said, you know what? We're just going to divvy the whole thing up.
Sorry, I'm doing the same thing I just asked you to do. I'm tagging three friends I know that aren't modern collectors but are huge Rick and Morty fans.
So look for randomly inserted autograph and sketch cards. It's basically across the entire product run. It's a little bit different than the normal guarantees in their other products, other Cryptozoic Entertainment products. So your ideal box is going to have an auto and a sketch card, but it's not guaranteed. So we're in for a treat. So here we have the Rick and Morty pack, 5 cards per pack.
And I say how jealous I am of you because I don't have I have basic cable, literally basic cable.
I watched it all on Daily Motion on the internet.
Really?
Right there. Wubba dubba dubba. Wubba lubba dub dub. Wubba lubba dub dub. See, I got it wrong earlier. character cards, and this is, unless they're all foil, which wasn't a... This is a rainbow. So I'm going to set that off to the side just in case that's a parallel. Here is another base parallel. And it is pretty witty, actually.
If you're watching on Twitter or Periscope, do a screenshot and share this to your feed. Let your friends know. Yeah, because I know that the people that I really respect their opinion say you can't miss this show, and I have not seen it. And I know that it's on, I believe, like Hulu has it, and I don't have, I have Netflix and HBO Now. And I know you can buy episodes on Apple.
Turbulent Juice. This was a unique episode.
Without the amount of time to binge it all. So I'm just jealous that you know what's going on these cards, but I get the zeitgeist of it all. I get it.
You get it? Yes.
You remember how they had such a following that they were able to get McDonald's to bring back the Szechuan sauce that they ran for Mulan?
Right.
It's insane.
Well, I was talking to a couple people at Cryptozoic the other day who were monitoring some of the chat about the product. And one website, called pop culture based did an article, but the slant was, do fans of the show really want a trading card set? And apparently the comment section was out of control. and certainly if you read through the comments, it would help you understand why these boxes are going for 200, because this is strictly a matter of supply and demand at this point.
I mean, just looking at it, these cards are almost making me laugh, and I don't even know the joke. So I can only imagine how, if you're in on it and you pull one of these cards, how many card sets out there can make you laugh?
Right? Yeah. So they're definitely onto something. And the show got not renewed, but another they've ordered another 80 episodes. So they are going to have plenty of source material for years to come for this license. So
it's one of those things, you know, my job is retirement, right? And yes. People hate that word. They're like, oh, I don't want to retire because I love working. And I do too. When I define retirement, it's that time when I finally get to take a month off and watch all of the 2000 Simpsons episodes, you know? Like, I do want to do that someday, watch every Simpsons episode. And similar to this, the other thing is animation can go on for so long because the characters don't age as they do with TV shows.
We have fun stickers.
So this could literally be, you know, we could end up having 30 years of this if Dan Harmon and the other creators' brains can sustain it.
Yeah, and they were fortunate to get, you know, all of the key autograph signers. The creator does the voices of Rick and Morty. His name is
Justin Roiland.
Yes, thank you. And he's got autos for all of the characters that he does in the show. It's not really a signature. Apparently, they stopped teaching cursive wherever he was educated. So he just prints his name. But it's a nice... I mean, it's nice.
Well, can you read it? Because that.
Oh yeah, you can definitely read it.
And so I'm actually out on. If you're a fan, gogts.net. You might see it on the board next to me. I'm on gogts.net. If you search Rick and Morty, you'll come up with the product guidelines. And sorry, I was talking so much about the show that I didn't actually go into all the specific types of things. But we have not only the checklist that you can download, but they did an awesome job with this product. Instead of just putting out a sell sheet or just a checklist, it's an entire visual. This is a feast what they did for the sell sheet / checklist this year, this product.
I made an error. This is one of the fun temporary tattoos. This is a sticker.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yes.
So the autographs are 1 in 48 packs, and considering there is 24 packs in a box, that puts 1 every other box, for those of you who don't work in math full-time like I do. Autograph signers include Chris Parnell, formerly of Saturday Night Live, right?
Here's a parallel. It's got the ray gun up at the top corner there.
Jess Harnell, who plays Roger, Graby, Bobby, Dog Soldier number 2, Reuben Ridley.
Scratch and sniff cards. Ivan, scratch and sniff cards.
I love it. So is there a Szechuan sauce card in here, or is that a later season? Because that just happened, so it's probably a later season, right?
Yeah.
Carrie Walgren, who plays multiple voices in the show. Maurice LaMarche, who also plays multiple noises in the show. And wasn't he on Futurama?
That sounds familiar, yeah.
Rob Paulson. Why do I know Rob Paulson? Ryan Ridley, Tom Kenny, Phil Hendry, and again,
we got Justin a 101 sketch card.
What? Boom. 1 of 1 sketch card. Now, are all the sketch cards 1 of 1?
1 of 1s. Yep. 1 of 1. Roberto Duke, the artist's signature. Thank you for that. We like knowing who they are.
Nice and clear and legible too.
You got it. Very cool.
And Rob, you watched the entire first season. That's how popular you knew this box break was going to be.
Yes.
Do you recognize that image on the card from the show? Do you remember what was going on there?
You know, the problem when you binge something, especially of this magnitude, it all kinds of runs together. I do recognize that character, but I'm struggling to put it into context. I was really hoping to pull a sketch card of one of the Meeseek characters. Hi, I'm Mr. Meeseeks. Oh, dude, you've got to check out a couple episodes of the first season.
I know. I want to. I hear it's intelligent, smart, fun, stupid, everything you want in a cartoon show.
Ants in My Eyes Johnson. The bad TV pitch man. Small base set, much smaller than other Cryptozoic sets. I want to say it's just 45 cards. Is that correct? Do you have that in front of you, Ivan?
I do. It is. I do. It is. Yes. I love you. We're married. Wait, no, what? Huh? Sorry, I was doing a little thing where I actually, dude, this new computer is so super
stand-ups. Stand-up cards. It's got everything you loved about collecting when you were a kid, man.
I'm actually posting a screenshot of the beautiful sell sheet / checklist that Cryptozoic has, along with the link to my Twitter. So I'm watch the breaks on Twitter. If you want to see that, I just tweeted it. Tweet at me.
And like I said, we're going to give away the hits. We're going to give away the base set. We're going to give away the inserts. And we're going to give away the parallels in groups. So there should be 4 to 5 winners out of this box. Yeah, they haven't missed a beat with these episodic images, as they say.
How many packs in? I've been doing a little multitasking. It's no excuse, I know.
I want to say about halfway.
I need a little clicker. I need to be like an ump. And clicker, you know?
There's a Mr. Meeseeks. That blue guy right there.
We're getting lots of thumbs up on the Facebook feed. I'm seeing them come across.
Spleen Mountain. Anatomy Land. A trip inside a human body after you've been shrunk down to miniature size.
Someone said...
another sticker.
They were... I think that might be where the sketch is from, because it was an amoeba, wasn't it?
Or it could be... there were some nasty viruses in there and all sorts of stuff.
Hey, I'm going back a little because I'm just now getting a chance to look at the comments. But James Campanil said, tell us what it smells like. Scratch it. Is that a violation of the giveaway? Or
yeah,
that...
I don't want to. Let me see. Hold on a second.
I mean, come on, though. Come on.
I don't want to scratch it.
Let us all know.
It actually smells. Hold on. I got to grab my glasses because there's something printed on the jar image. Hold on.
Do not sniff, may be toxic.
So it smells like some sort of liniment or, let's see. Yeah, cologne or aftershave.
All right.
It's definitely a funky type of cologne.
Well, again, they definitely have to be setting themselves up for a Szechuan sauce insert in later seasons if they make it to whatever season that was that they did the whole thing with the Szechuan sauce. By the way, that was my goal for tonight, to say Szechuan sauce seven times. That should have been the poll of the week. What's the over-under on times Ivan will say Szechuan sauce on tonight's show?
Yes, that is a second one-of-one sketch card.
What?
Boom!
Whoa! Giveaway.
Eric, S-C-H-O-D-Z.
Well, what's great is, again, because their sell sheet is so comprehensive, they have the list of all the artists on it. So give me just a minute to scroll back down. It's a 14-page sell sheet that you can access at gogts.net if you're curious who the autograph signers and sketch card artists are. In Rick and Morty Trading Card Season 1, Eric Schock, S-C-H-O-C-K. So sketch cards are 1 in 16 packs. So that's actually not unheard of, hitting 2 in one box.
I like it.
Yeah, 24 packs per box. So you could conceivably hit a sketch card and an autograph in a box.
Yeah, like I said, I think that's your cherry box right there, if that happens. The cerebral cortex carousel out of Anatomy Land.
Let's jump over to the
Anatomy Land has its own insert set.
Wow. The most recent sketch card sold for $159.
That's great.
But some earlier ones only sold for $60, $80, $40. So I think it depends on the subject. The one that sold for $160 is Rick and Morty, I think, the two characters. Driving a space shuttle or something. As opposed to the $40 one, which is a picture of what looks like a machine.
So, yes, all the character insert cards are on this rainbow foil board.
Wow. This sketch card of looks like an evil Rick. Or does Rick have a brother?
There was one episode where there was a ton of Ricks. More Mr. Meeseeks.
We're hearing Greg Reamers must send me a tweet because he knows that's the only way I'll see it.
Principal Vagina. Principal Vagina is a character.
Just have unfortunate names.
Last couple packs here.
Greg Reamersma pointed out something that the asset also told me in my ear earlier. Doesn't Tom Kenny do SpongeBob? So, yes, the voice
That's
of SpongeBob
right.
has autographs in this product.
Look at this. Another great temporary tattoo. too funny. Next to last pack here, and then I'm going to show you the breakdown of how we're going to divvy this up so that everybody, as many people as possible, can get a taste of some Rick and Morty. Last pack.
Pretty cool. So don't forget, if you're just tuning in, this is your first time, you've never seen how we do things here, you do have to follow us on Twitter, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. In order to enter to win, but you don't have to be watching via Twitter, even though you can on Periscope, as you'll see from our pinned tweet when you go to our page. You can be watching from any of the channels, but you do have to enter via Twitter.
All right.
Thank you,
Barry. One winner is going to get what is sure to be a complete base set in here. This stack. Then another winner will get all the base parallel cards. And there were several of those. Okay.
Wow.
So here is the base parallels. Yes.
I got to go to watch count real quick before I can substantiate this, but my gosh, have you looked at the sold prices on some of these?
No,
Justin
sir.
Roiland autograph, numbered to 50. Number 10 of 50. That's not even exceptionally rare. It's rare. It's not exceptionally rare. Sold for $600.
Wow.
Best offer.
Wow.
Chris Parnell out of 100 sold for $200. Tom Kenny, 300, numbered to 50. It's crazy.
All right.
Oof.
How did, well, there was, oh, wait a second.
What'd you find?
Hold on a second. There was a, there literally, the sticker card was stuck to Rob Paulson.
You are kidding me.
No.
You're kidding me. Wow. Double check the focus real quick. Does it look good, James? Sorry, it was kind of blurry on mine. Okay, cool.
Okay.
You're all good. All good. Wow. That's so there haven't funny. Been any that I've seen. Well, let's double check the word auto. I haven't seen any Rob Paulsons hit eBay yet.
But that's two sketch cards and an auto out of that box.
Which just goes to show you the odds are just approximations.
Across the entire production run, yep.
So we literally, yeah. So that was a box, again, 1 in 48 packs for the auto, but that doesn't mean that they exclude the sketches at 1 in 16 necessarily from your box. That is hot.